Oh, hey, we're back. Thanks for coming back. So we're gonna wind this coil. And what I've done here is just pulled out the magnet wire. There's only two pieces of wire in here. One piece is very short and it's kind of just a standard little chunk of hookup wire. The other piece, wonder how much of this wire we need. It doesn't say in the kit. That's okay. We can figure this out. We're intelligent beings, aren't we? Well, we like to think so.
Okay. Let's see here. Now, somewhere I set Darwin's kit that he lent me. I'd like to thank him again. So here's the toroid. Yep. And if the camera will focus, if I zoom out here. Now this is a bit hard to see, but not impossible. You can see here that this winding goes over and then into the toroid and around. So it's kind of an over-under from that side. And I'm just... And the instructions say 20 turns. So I'm going to just peel off some wire here. I don't know if you need this wire for anything else. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do here. We'll be right back after these station breaks. Okay, what I did with there was I wound a couple of turns to get an idea about how much that is going to take up. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. There's quite a bit here. I think the instructions say there was some ridiculous amount of wire. There's like 4 foot there. Now here it says to wind this tightly. Okay. Well, I'm going to just tempt fate and peel off about, I don't know, maybe 1.5 feet of wire. So, I'm just going to look like an idiot here. And, so there's one. There. Is 1 turn. There is. Every time you go through the center, it's a pass. That's 2. What'll happen is I'll get down to 19, and there won't be enough wire left. And I'm kind of just trying to, it says tightly, so I'm trying to pull this up reasonably tight. And there are a number of videos on YouTube about how to wind these. This coil isn't microscopic, so it shouldn't be an issue. Now, don't get too rough with this, and maybe not drop these. They're made out of a powdered metal that's compressed, I think, and glued together. If you drop this, it may, I'm using the word may, potentially shatter. But since this coil looks pretty stout, I think we can get a little rough with it. What do we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I got 7, so I'm about halfway done. I still got a reasonable amount of wire left. And there's 20. So, there we go. The wire is pretty stiff, so don't worry too much about it unwinding. So here's what I've got. Let me just count it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. So we got her spaced out. My coil looks pretty much like Darwin's coil. Let's see. So I've got, I don't know, about that much left. What is that, about 5 inches? But there's quite a bit left there. There's nothing to stop you from unwinding this other than you might break the wire if you fatigue it too much. I can't remember what this wire was. It's 22 gauge. Okay. So I suggest you clip it. Okay. So we'll just do a little look-see here and see what we're supposed to do. There's nothing wrong with, you know, looking at this stuff and fitting the parts. Especially before you go trimming things. That's interesting. Is his like that?
His is different. So we run into a tiny little snag.
Let's see here. What the hell is this? Okay. Well, on this kit, looks like, not sure, looks like these are the okay. I think this is P for primary. And this is the secondary. There's a drawing here. Really? That's interesting. I don't see circuit trace going anywhere there. Well, we can always look at the schematic.
At least I can. I mean, if you're really unfamiliar with electronics, this may be a bit of a boggle. We'll just tough it out. Okay. One side of that coil goes to ground. The small coil, which says one turn here. Here it says 20 turns. So it goes to the collector of a transistor. And it goes to a resistor R2.
Where is that resistor? I don't see it. But here is the transistor. This is Q1. Yeah. And that goes over to the antenna. This is one side of the main coil, the one with the more turns, the primary they're calling it. The other side goes to, there's one of the, okay, so here and here are the big coil, and I believe this is here. That's the other side, and ground. We can find that out quick enough. It never hurts to stop and ask some questions. This is how you stay out of trouble. So I'm just gonna, yeah, okay. So that pad right there, on this kit anyway, this is the primary, here and here. This is the secondary from here to here. This pad actually goes to ground. You can see where they both go up to this transistor Q1. No brainer. Okay, so we need a little soldering. Okay. So I've got that straightened out in my mind. Let me just check here. It says cut the wire 1/4 inch from the outside of the toroid and strip it back. Preferred method is to use heat from the soldering iron. Cut a 1-inch piece of magnet wire, strip it, and tin it 1/4 inch. Solder one to the pad in the center. slide the toroid over it, and solder the other to the other pad to the right of the toroid. So basically, if I'd have read the instructions, I'd have answered my own damn question. Way to go. Okay, well, we'll wait for the soldering iron to heat up. We'll talk a little bit about the tools you might need here. I didn't talk about that ahead of time. Just some solder. This is 64. This is actually lead-based solder, so I'm sure the world is going to come to a crashing end. A little pair of cutters might be in order. Needle nose. There's some hook nose needle nose. You know, it might be more appropriate for you. I like these flat duckbill pliers for smashing stuff out and straightening stuff. And here's some circuit board kind of trim. These are flush mount. And they're just cutters. They might be more appropriate. One other thing you might want to get a hold of, and I'll be back in a tick. One other thing you may like, up to you, is a craft knife. This is actually an X-Acto branded knife, and you'll need some extra blades. I find they're invaluable for trimming or cutting or helping me along my way with things. Okay. So I've managed to misplace the coil already. Already things are getting out of control. That's why you have extra sets of pliers. So I'm just going to trim that back. And we'll save this piece. Okay, so... I've got the soldering iron heated up here. I'm just going to use this stand. I said to strip the wire back using the heat from the soldering iron and some solder. So we'll do one side, keeping in mind that the heat may travel down the wire and burn your hand, so we'll use the duckbill platypus. Touch that on there and see if you can burn that off of there. The only downside about this method is it may not do your solder iron any good. Another way to do this is to put a lot of solder on there and a ball will form on the underside of the solder iron and throw solder. And then you can use that drip to help burn that off. That is some damn good. Okay, method two is to just get in there with your old craft knife and start scraping. Some sandpaper might be appropriate. Okay, that just is not going to burn through that enamel. You can do this on really thin wire, but this thicker stuff that just doesn't work so great on. And you can see, if I show you, if I zoom out, I've got one side, but not the other. So get that straightened up. Man, that stuff is damn tough, which is good. The last thing you want is some crummy insulation. You're winding a coil and have it break through and touch another side and all your
work is gone to heck.
Okay, that's pretty good. Well, okay, what I see is going to happen here is I'm going to have to scrape this coil. just wipe that off. A little alcohol might be appropriate. And like I mentioned before, soldering stand would be appropriate. The one of the other tools you might like is a small, very small screwdriver. And you can use that to form the leads around. And just bend that.
It'll put a nice little radius on things for you.
Just try and straighten that up and get look like we gave a damn. I don't think this is super duper critical. So the instructions say to solder this down. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put just a tiny bit of solder on here first. Which just flowed out like $1 million. And tack my little wire down here. I'm going to heat the wire and then slowly set it down there. Just that quick. Okay.
The more you dink around soldering something, the more the solder gets overheated. And the more of a mess it makes. Okay.
So I'm going to form my leads up here. And actually I trimmed that a little bit short on one side. It's not, man, it's gonna be close.
Well, what I could do, is cheat and use the longest of the leads to go to that.
I'm pretty clever, aren't I? No, I'm not. Okay, there we go. So I've got that bent. I don't have to bend that too many times. Okay, so
a little wire scraping is in order. Sorry, I'm gonna have to
Let you go for a tick here.
Okay, after a lot of fooling around and using the combo kind of method here of scraping that and heating it and scraping it and heating it, I've got down to this point. So one side on the...
I want that focus. Please focus. One side of this. This is the underside. This wire over here goes up and over. I'm going to mount it on the board like that. And I bent a little leg in there.
And I'm going to trim those back just a tiny bit.
So I've been fitting this and trimming this and looking at this and just fiddling about. And I think I've got it about where I want it. I want to move this wire a tiny bit so that the wire is... Actually, what I'm going to do is just unsolder it real quick like a bunny.
Trim that leg down a little bit.
And move it so that the wire comes
more out of the center of that little pad. And this is all very fiddly. I'm sure if you just solder this down and get it over and done with, it's fine.
Okay.
A little more trimming is in order.
And okay.
I've lost my damn craft knife. This is the reason you work someplace quiet, so that the dog and the kids and the little woman don't interrupt you. Or the cat. I'm just giving her a good looking over here.
And I'm just going to touch up these ends a little bit.
It's downhill from here, trust me. Okay,
I'm going to solder the one closest to the board first.
These things aren't mentioned in the kit itself.
Actually, I'm going to put down just a little, heat the pad. And put down just a little dab of solder. And it flows out nice. Get some good solder and some good circuit boards and it's no brainer. Okay. The other thing you may want the small screwdriver for is to help you push these parts around, but I don't think this is going to be... Actually, I put so little solder on there it isn't taking. Okay, and I'm going to use the blade of this small screwdriver to push this down. It's not being very cooperative. I'm going to move the coil a tiny bit. Little quick solder job, boom, and it's done. Okay, so here's what we've got so far. Just tacked on there. Now I'll form this over. This just goes over.
Read the instructions. Solder the toroid. Start by soldering the one at the underside. It even says this stuff. If I read this stuff, I wouldn't have to think it out. Actually, what they do in the instructions, they tell you to solder this jumper first and then fix it. But since I wanted to do a little fitting there, I did it a little bit backwards. So according to instructions, solder this jumper wire first on there, flip it over, mount it, and then do these two. It's to help, what it is to help hold the coil down so you aren't chasing it around. So my way is not the appropriate way. Or is it? Well, we'll find out in a bit.